In this video, we'd like to present our very earliest of impressions of the Tesla Cybertruck, take a look at its specs and quickly compare it with the Ford F-150 Lightning and the Rivian R1T in our much favored side-by-side comparison. The adage that goes in the world of products is, believe only when you see it. That couldn't have applied any better than now with the Cybertruck. I am honestly not disappointed one bit with anything about the Cybertruck because I never believed the announcements all these years. In fact, you may have not seen anything about the truck so far on our channel because we simply did not look into it. That's until yesterday. Having said that, I fully understand the remorse that's now being put out all over the internet, particularly with the price of the Cybertruck. That's significantly higher than the one announced in 2019, notwithstanding that a lot has changed since. The Cybertruck comes in three trims. Very limited information is currently made available on the rear-wheel drive base trim. The all-wheel drive dual motor and the top tri-motor trim named Cyberbeast have some meaningful details now available, all of which we have presented in this chart. Some of these too could change, mind you, particularly after we have more data on hand, especially with the real-world range. For our side-by-side comparison, we'll focus on the all-wheel drive middle trim, which also appears to us as the best option currently. All the three trims are 223.7 inches long, 95 inches wide, that's 86.6 inches with the mirrors folded, and 70.5 inches tall. The all-wheel drive has an estimated listed range of 340 miles, and the Cyberbeast has a listed estimated range of 320 miles. Tesla offers a range extender option that could push those numbers to 470 plus miles and 440 plus miles. The rear-wheel drive available in 2025 has an estimated range of 250 miles. A 0 to 60 in 6.5 seconds, a top speed of 112 miles per hour, and a towing capability of 7,500 pounds. That's all the information that's currently available on the rear-wheel drive trim. We will leave the rear-wheel drive out of the conversation here and focus mainly on the other two trims. The performance variables on the top two trims are 4.1 seconds 0 to 60, 112 miles per hour top speed on the all-wheel drive, and 2.6 seconds 0 to 60 and 130 miles per hour top speed on the Cyberbeast. The all-wheel drive lifts 600 horsepower and 7,434 pound-feet of torque, while the Cyberbeast offers 845 horsepower and 10,296 pound-feet of torque. Yes, the torque does at first appear as a typo, and we will try to get more on this later. Both the trims have a listed total cargo of 120 cubic feet to 11,000 pounds and have a curb weight of 6,603 pounds and 6,843 pounds respectively. Both have 17.44 inches of ground clearance, an important variable for trucks, are stated to be delivered in 2024 and are priced at an estimated $79,990 and $99,990 respectively. The all-wheel drive under $80,000 could qualify for the US federal tax credit by current rules. Another factor that makes it the better option amongst those on offer currently. The rear-wheel drive is showing an estimated price of $60,690. But like everything, don't trust any price until it's your day to reserve with the $250. The prices can change and probably will be adjusted to the change in demand. Even with the many cancellations that will happen and would have happened regardless. So take everything at actuals when relevant. It's an 800-volt architecture with details I have yet to look into. particularly to see how it works with the existing superchargers. They will probably split the system into two 400 volt ones with some tuning for the AC compressor, etc. This we'll see when the product is on hand. The 250 kilowatt peak speed does look a tad slow. This vehicle will be up against the Silverados, and it's interesting how some of the other vehicles have improved their charging recently. Tesla 4680 Model Y that was discontinued, on the other hand, was reported to have charging performance that was way below expectations. This truck has 4682, and that's what makes it fully US manufactured. Just a point. Its 8 cameras and technology leave little doubt in mind. That part seems well managed with every Tesla. The Cybertruck is wider than both the Rivian R1T and the Ford F-150 Lightning at 86.6 inches. The F-150 is the longest of the three at 232 inches, but the Cybertruck is longer than the Rivian R1T's 217 inches. At 70.5 inches, however, the Cybertruck is the shortest of the three. The range of Tesla vehicles is often short of the listed figure. The 352 miles of Rivian R1T beats all three, and with its recently unlocked max pack, it could easily reach over 400 miles. The range has been a big disappointment with the Cybertruck, especially after the high promises from 2019. The Cybertruck battery pack size has yet not been disclosed. Its 250 kilowatt max DC charge rate is a bit disappointing, as stated earlier. I would have expected it to be more in the 300 plus kilowatt region. I need to get deeper into the performance variables and will like to delve into them in a later video. But never the same, we are listing them here as listed by Tesla. At 120.9 cubic feet, it appears to have a decent cargo capacity with a bed that's probably 6 feet by 4 feet. Just my feeling upon the first glance. Its 6,603 pounds of weight too sits between that of the Rivian R1T's 7,148 pounds and the F-150's 6,015 pounds. The Cybertruck's 17.44 inches of ground clearance is significantly higher than the other two and could be important when off-roading, along with its robust seeming build. Its price too sits exactly under the tax credit bracket and has been the main cause of the disappointment, currently being vented all over. Though, like said before, is the most for those who really believed specs provided years ago. The Cybertruck looks like a product that will eventually grow on the market and gradually gain acceptance. Even with the much expected cancellations, Tesla will produce and sell it for years at a stretch, and it will hopefully provide Tesla with that important diversity in its product lineup. I will look forward to driving it like the many of you, and we look to documenting and publishing more videos of the experience. See you in the next one. Cheers. We'd like to make a correction to our previous video on Tesla's Q4 prices and updates. In the video, in the part on the incentives on Model 3 and Y, we erroneously stated the same ones on both the Model 3 and the Model Y. As a matter of fact, the stated likely reduction to $3,750 from the full $7,500 of tax credit from Jan 1 is applicable only to the Tesla Model 3 as put out by Tesla. The Model Y is expected to enjoy the full $7,500 in tax credit. We sincerely apologize for the error.